In this video, we will focus on enhancing the plants. We will be working on tonal range, particularly of these two plants visible in the foreground. We will be enhancing highlights in these areas to make the image more three-dimensional. By making these two plants stronger and brighter, we will add more depth to the image. So to enhance presence of these two elements in the image, we need to add another adjustment layer. I'm hitting tabulator to bring all my panels back. And as you remember, to add another adjustment layer, we need to move down to this little icon and select from the drop-down menu again the curves adjustment layer. And that one I'm going to remain and call it plant. Let's reduce the amount of space taken by the layers panel. So now to adjust highlights and shadows in the plants, we need to zoom in a little bit, especially for the sampling part. So by creating this adjustment layer, I have the properties window visible, and now I'm going to be using the targeted adjustment tool again and sampling from the area that I want to make brighter. So I will be sampling in a little bit darker part. I just want to make this part maybe a little bit brighter. And the second sample I will take from darker part of the plant, let's say around here. So I'm going to zoom out now, since I will be looking at all those plants. I can close the layers panel, it's not needed at this point. And let's pull this first point representing highlights. Let's pull it upwards to make the highlights stronger. Remember that we will mask that layer, so I don't need to worry about changes in the background or in the face. I will just mask the plant. I'm not going to make shadows deeper, so I will leave this point as it was at the beginning. Okay, so let's get our layers panel back. I'm hitting function F7 to get it visible again, and I will be masking these two plants. So I need to hit on the icon representing mask and then hit Command I to swap the mask from white to black. Now to apply those adjustments, I will be painting with a white color on the black mask, so B for brush. The sample is perfect. Let's increase size of the brush a bit, and opacity 20 is fine. Let's just paint over these areas in the plant that I would like to increase the highlights. I can go for 4, that will give me opacity 40. I just hit 4 on my keyboard, and I just want to make highlights brighter. I don't want to paint over the whole plant, as it will make it equally bright. And by saying that, I mean it will make it flat. By enhancing only highlights in the plant area, it's adding volume to the object. It's making it more three-dimensional. Okay, so I have painted over this one, and let's paint a bit over that one. I have ignored that part of the plant, despite the fact that it's the second one on the foreground. I don't want this part to be bright, because all the bright parts of the image are catching the viewer's attention. They are just popping out, and I want to make only this part stronger, that will visually help me, that will be helpful to build the composition, to enhance the image that I wanted, and to make it more effective. The point is to make all those adjustments in a really constructive way to make conscious decisions. Only this way we can achieve good results in a very unique way. As you remember, I've mentioned at the beginning that the plants are forming leading lines on which the composition of the photo is based. So I'm going to make those lines a bit stronger. I have decreased opacity. I have hit 20 on my keyboard and just painting over these elements here. Okay, let's now press tabulator to get rid of the panels of the tools to have a bit more space to look at the image, and let's just bring back the layers. So I'm hitting function F7 and I want to see how these adjustments affect the image. Okay, I have made the highlights brighter. Now they are a bit stronger. I'm tempted to push them a little bit further. So I hit on the thumbnail representing the adjustment layer, and I will see if by pushing it further it's going to help or if it's too much. That way this part got brighter. Let's see if I still have texture visible in those parts of the image. Okay, I think it's fine, so we can keep it that way. By making the highlights stronger, you can see how these two shapes are creating the leading lines. The same this part. On the mask, you can see where the adjustments are applied. So that way it's helping me to strengthen my composition. It's making the leading lines stronger and it's really holding the viewer's eye in the central part of the image. These two plants are framing as well in a very beautiful way face of the model. By adjusting tonal range on the props, we have completed the first part of the edit. In the second module, we will polish the image by adding a matte finish, by toning, and finally sharpening the photo. See you in the next module.